Pyxel is a powerful game development library that would allow you to easily create retro-style computer games. So how we create levels or worlds in games? Almost always we would use a technique called tilemaps. So in this lesson I will explain what tilemap technique is and what are the benefits of using it. I will show you how to create tilemaps using Pyxel Resource Editor, and I will teach you how to show the world from the tilemap in your game. A tilemap is a technique that used to create levels or environments by dividing them into a grid of small, uniform-sized squares, which are called tiles. These tiles can represent different elements, terrain, objects, obstacles, or even characters within the game world. By arranging and combining different tiles, we can build complex and visually appealing game environments. Using tilemaps have several benefits. First, it saves memory. It saves time on designing different elements. Instead of designing unlimited amount of different things, the world would consist of certain amount of different building blocks. So no wonder that tilemaps are used in many games. Super Mario, StarCraft, literally you name it. Any 2D or isometric game is likely to use tilemaps. Let's see how we can create a simple tilemap in Pyxel Resource Editor. We open Resource Editor using Pyxel Edit and then the resource file name command. In our case it is Pyxel Edit My Game. Now we already know how to use Sprite Editor, but we need to create a tile. Tile in our case would be just another sprite. I have created two tiles, one empty, which would represent a corridor or other empty space in my game. Another one is the wall. I also had to move our player sprite in the sprite bank to the right. This will require some updates to the player class at a certain point. When we created the necessary sprites, we need to click Save to make sure that all our changes are saved to the disk, and then we move to the tile editor section. Here we would be putting tiles by selecting them here and putting them here. We will create a rather small world with the size of 16 by 16 tiles, and each tile is 8 by 8 pixels. I also often place my player sprite in the tile map to indicate the initial player location. These tricks would also work for placing NPCs. When we are happy with our world, let's not forget to click Save, and then we can finally return to our code editor. I like to add a special class that would represent our logical world grid. Let's create a file worldpy and create class world in it. I would also like to add some constants to the world class. For example, I always find it useful to have height and width constants in my world class. As you will see later, we would rely on them in quite a few cases. Also, it is always helpful to separate the size in tiles and in pixels, so I will add the comment here, just so I have something which will help me avoiding confusion with this too. In Pyxel, when we try to get information about the sprite, it will return a sprite index. It is a bit inconvenient, so I will also create an enum, and I will be able to operate using more meaningful names. I will call this enum world items. Right now I have a mistake in defining the world items. I confused X and Y in my case, but I will fix it later. My constructor for the world class will take tilemap as an input. I will also make sure it is initialized in the main class. Here I need to provide what tilemap I am using. I always can check the number in the resource editor. Now, going back to the word class constructor, let's see line by line what's going on here. On the line 22, we are creating an empty list or array, which will contain the logical grid map of our world. On lines 23 and 24, I am creating variables to hold the initial position of the player. Then, I am using a nested for loop. In this nested loop, I am reading the tilemap values from Pyxel and compare those values with the world item enum I have created. If it is a player though, instead of putting the player to my world, I put corridor, but I record the player initial coordinates. Here is, by the way, the corrected world item class. Now it is the time to change our main class too. In the update function, we added to our player the ability to move in all four directions. The most interesting changes are in the draw function. Let's check them out. So, before drawing the player, which is important, otherwise the tile map is going to cover the player. So before drawing the player, we will draw the tile map. In this case, we are basically iterating over elements in our tile map, and then we call a special function to draw a world item. In this function, we use the same Pyxel BLT method, but we make sure that the appropriate sprite is written in the appropriate space. So let's recap the cryptic BLT method. First, I provide the coordinates of the sprite in pixels. Basically, where I want this sprite to be shown. As I get tile coordinates as an input, I will need to multiply that by tile size to get the value in pixels. Then, I specify the sprite bank, which is 0 in my case. After which, I need to calculate the pixels coordinate of my tile in the sprite bank. That's a bit confusing, but basically, I need to multiply the logical tile x and y from the tilemap editor by tile size. Please drop me a comment if it sounds confusing, because it probably is. I will try to explain this in a bit more details if I get 10 comments. Finally, we need to provide tile size, which is the size of the sprite that we need to show on the screen. Going back to the draw method, I changed it slightly so it takes the world item player sprite coordinates instead of using what was the constant in the player class. Finally, I also made sure that my player appears where I want it according to the tile map, so I provide my player with the link to my world. Now, you can probably argue that it should be the other way around. In an ideal world, map would have the link to the player, not the other way around. I would probably agree, but just to make changes as minimal as possible, I chose to provide player with the link to the world. So now my player has access to the initial coordinates by accessing world. Let's see how it all would work. Now we can see our world from the tile map and the player in this world. Of course, our player doesn't care about the walls yet, so it can move through them. In the next lesson, we will learn how we could detect the collision between the player and walls and other objects. It was Test Encoder. If you enjoyed the video, please hit like button, subscribe to my channel and drop me a comment. It all really helps me to stay motivated and publish more content for you, my friends. See you around!